Let's take a look at this limit together. The limit as x goes to infinity of 7x cubed plus 5x plus 3 all over x cubed minus 1. This is what we call a rational function. I have a polynomial on top and a polynomial on bottom. And I'm looking at the limit as x goes to infinity of this function. So what that's actually going to provide us with is some information about the behavior of this rational function on its ends, or what we might call end behavior. So how do we actually go about evaluating this limit? Well, the first thing we can do is we can just think about what's happening to the top and what's happening to the bottom as x goes to infinity. So as x goes to infinity, if I look at my numerator here, I've got 7x cubed plus 5x plus 3. So as x gets larger and larger, this numerator is also going to get larger and larger. Right? So this numerator is approaching infinity as x approaches infinity. What about the denominator? Well, on the bottom, I've got x cubed minus 1. And as x goes to infinity, this is also going to get arbitrarily large. Right? The minus 1 isn't going to make any difference in the scheme of infinity. So my denominator then is approaching infinity as well. So I see that what happens is I get this form infinity over infinity. And this happens very often when you take the limit as x goes to infinity of a rational function. So this is what's called an indeterminate form, this infinity over infinity. And what that means, what indeterminate form means, essentially, is that I don't know what the answer to this limit is just by knowing that the form is infinity over infinity. So that I need to do a little bit more work of some sort. So what we've been kind of emphasizing is when you get these indeterminate forms, like infinity over infinity, you're going to need to do more algebra of some sort. Somehow rewrite this expression so that we can try to take the limit in a different way. Now, there's a special way that we do this often for these rational functions when you're taking the limit at infinity. And that method is to divide every term by the term with the highest power in the denominator. So in this case, my highest power term in the denominator is this x cubed. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide every term in this expression by x cubed so that I get something that looks like this. And then from here, I am simply going to reduce or simplify. So if I simplify this, I get 7 plus 5 over x squared plus 3 over x cubed in my numerator. And then on the bottom, I get 1 minus 1 over x cubed. Okay, so I've done some algebra to rewrite this limit in maybe what seems like a strange way. But now we're going to try to take this limit as x goes to infinity again and see what happens. And the way we're going to do that specifically is just think about term by term what's happening to each of these terms as x goes to infinity. So first thing I have is I have this 7. Now as x goes to infinity, 7 is just a constant, so it just stays 7. Then I've got 5 over x squared. Now as x goes to infinity, I've got a fraction whose denominator is getting larger and larger and larger. And we know that that means that the fraction overall is approaching 0. So 5 over x squared approaches 0. So does 3 over x cubed by the same logic. And so does 1 over x cubed by the same logic. And then in the denominator, I have this other constant term 1. Oh, that's going to go to 1 as x goes to infinity. So then what I see is that overall, my numerator is approaching 7, and my denominator is approaching 1, so this expression then is approaching 7. So then what we've determined is the limit as x goes to infinity of my function here equals 7. And what that tells me is that I have a horizontal asymptote on the right-hand side at 7. And we'll see that on a graph in just a second. So this tells me about the end behavior on the right-hand side of my graph, but let's say I also want to know about the end behavior on the left-hand side of my graph. In that case, what I'd like to do is look at the limit as x goes to negative infinity of the same function. And what we're going to do is we're just going to reuse the work we already did in rewriting this expression. So I'm just going to skip straight to the form 7 plus 5 over x squared plus 3 over x cubed all over 1 minus 1 over x cubed. And we'll look at the limit as x goes to negative infinity of that expression. We're going to think about this in the exact same way. I'm going to think about what's happening to each of my terms as x goes to negative infinity. So 7 is still 7 as x goes to negative infinity. And then I have all these little fractions, 5 over x squared, 5 over x cubed, 1 over x cubed. So in 5 over x squared, right, my denominator is getting bigger and bigger as x goes to negative infinity, and that denominator is actually going to be positive since it's x squared. So that's going to go to 0. That's the same situation as we had up here when x was going to positive infinity. But what about 3 over x cubed? Now here, my denominator is going to be negative, right, because I'm cubing a negative number. So my denominator is going to be getting larger and larger in the negative direction. So 3 over negative million, 3 over negative a billion, and so on. But this is still going to approach 0. It's just going to approach 0 from the left-hand side. And same with 1 over x cubed. That's going to go to 0. And then, of course, 1 just approaches 1. So it looks like then we get the same limit here. Now, in this case, we got the same limit as x goes to infinity as x goes to negative infinity, but that won't necessarily always happen. There can be situations where you get a different horizontal asymptote on the two different sides of your graph. So just keep in mind that that is a possibility. But in this case, what we see is our function is approaching 7, a y value of 7, for x is going to positive infinity and x is going to negative infinity. So let's just quickly look at the graph and see what this looks like. So here I've graphed our rational function, 7x cubed plus 5x plus 3 all over x cubed minus 1. And let's just take a look at the end behavior and see what's happening here. All right, and I just zoomed out a little for us there. So let's look at the behavior as x goes to positive infinity. That is, what's happening to my function values as x gets larger and larger and larger? Well, we see that it looks like our function values or our y values are approaching a line. And specifically, this is the line y equals 7. This is a horizontal asymptote. As x gets larger and larger, my y values are going to get closer and closer and closer to this line y equals 7, though we'll never actually reach that line. And then the same thing on the left-hand side of my graph. As x goes to negative infinity, I see that I'm approaching that same asymptote. So y is approaching 7.